Hi, good morning everyone. How are you all? I hope all are fine and safe at home. Okay children, today we are going to discuss about Unit 3, Matter Around Us. Topics to be covered: Introduction and Physical Nature of Matter. Okay, what is matter? Anything which occupies space and has mass is called matter. Some example pictures are here. Matter is all around us. The air you breathe, the water that you drink, the chair, pen, pencil, clock, the food that we eat, the things that you see and touch every day. Matter around us. Whether it may be living things or non-living things, the picture that you see here, example of matter. Okay, let us discuss what is matter. Can exist in one of three main states. Already you learnt in lower classes: solid, liquid and gas. The another state also that is called plasma. Matter is composed of tightly packed particles. A solid will retain its shape, square, rectangle, triangle, like that. The particles are not free to move around because it is closely packed. Liquid matter is made up of more loosely packed particles. Here some examples of here: solid, liquid, gases and plasma. What is plasma? Plasma is by far the most common form of matter. Plasma in the stars and in the tenuous space between them makes up over 99% of the visible universe. And perhaps most of that which is not visible. On earth we live upon an island of ordinary matter. So the matter can exist solid, liquid, gas and plasma. We discussed matter. Now all matter is made up of? Very good children, atoms. All matter is made up of atoms, which are turned in made up of protons, neutrons and electrons. Atoms come together to form molecules, which are the building blocks for all types of matter, according to Washington State University. See here the atom particles: electron, proton and neutron. Electron is negative particle, proton is positive particle, neutron is neutral. The nucleus contains inside the atoms. So what is atom? Atom is the smallest constituent unit of ordinary matter that constitutes a chemical element. Every solid, liquid, gas and plasma is composed of neutral. Every solid, liquid, gas and plasma is composed of neutral or ionized atoms. Atoms are extremely small, that means tiny particle, typically around 100 picometer across. So definition of matter. Matter is defined as anything that has mass and takes up space. Here it has volume. Mass is a measure of the matter in an object. Mass is a measure of the matter in an object. While weight is a measure of gravity pull on an object. So we know very well now what is matter, what is mass, and what is weight. Already we have studied the atom, particles, protons, neutrons are packed together into center of the atom. What is containing in the center of the atom? The protons, neutrons are packed together into the center of the atom, which is called a nucleus. The proton and neutron are packed together into center of the atom, which is called the nucleus, and the electrons, which are very much smaller, right, around the outside. Electrons around the outside. When people draw pictures of atoms, they show the electrons like satellites spinning around the earth in orbits. Most of an atom is empty space. So we have discussed already what is matter. Everything around is matter. Matter can be solid, liquid, gas, and very good children, plasma. Here some pictures are here. Toys are matter. Balloons are matter. Water also matter. Some matter has parts that are too small to see, but we can see the structure of atom using various microscopes. Atom is very small. Atom, they are so small that you cannot see them with your eyes or even with a standard microscope. A standard sheet of paper is about millions of atoms thick. A standard sheet of paper is about millions of atoms thick. Science has come up with a technology to identify structure of atoms. Scanning electron microscope, SEM, and tunneling electron microscope, TEM, which uses electricity to map atoms. Another one, ARM. What is ARM? Atomic resolution microscope. Atomic resolution electron microscope utilize high power magnetic lenses to produce magnified images of the atomic details of matter. Doing so involves placing samples inside the magnetic objective lens, where the magnetic fields of up to a few tesla are always excited. The scanning electron microscopes are here, produces an image sampled by scanning the surface with the focused beam of electrons. STM, scanning tunneling microscope, widely used in both industrial and fundamental research to obtain atomic scale images of metal surfaces. The another one is TEM. These three type of microscope, we can easily see the structure of atom. The transmission electron microscope is used to view thin specimens like tissue sections, molecules, etc., through which electrons can pass, generating a projection image. The TEM is analogous in many ways to be conventional, that means compound light microscope. Next, we are going to discuss about activity 1. It's given in your reader. Take a few crystals of sugar. Observe them carefully with the help of magnifying lens. Which of the shape given above resembles a sugar crystal? A. Is correct? No. B. No. C. Very good children. No. D. I
and E and F. Which one is look like sugar crystal? The answer is, which of the shapes given above resembles a sugar crystal? The answer is D. Now place a few sugar crystals in a teaspoon full of water. What happens to the sugar crystals? See here, one beaker is there. So beaker inside, water and sugar molecules also there. The sugar is completely dissolved in water. So sugar is a soluble substance. A sugar crystal is also made up of molecules. When sugar dissolves in water, the sugar crystals break down and the molecules of sugar get distributed in water. So the sugar is completely dissolved in water. This makes water sweet to taste. Now we can see the sugar molecules? No, because the sugar is a soluble substance, is completely dissolved in water. The sugar molecules are extremely small. That is why we are not able to see them. Small amount of matter has many millions of molecules. So 1 million is equal to 10 lakhs. Step by step, how can we write in the activity? So easily we understood this. Take a few crystals, few sugar crystals. Now place a few sugar crystals in a teaspoon full of water. What happens to the sugar crystals? Like everything else, a sugar crystal is also made up of, very good children, molecules. Because atoms is very tiny. When sugar dissolves in water, the sugar crystals break down and the molecules of sugar get distributed in the water. This makes the water taste sweet. Sugar molecules are extremely small, that's why we are not able to see them. A small amount of any matter will have many millions molecules. So 1 million is equal to 10 lakhs. So do you know children, besides solids, liquid, gas, there are two more states, plasma and Bose-Einstein content states. Plasma is not a common state of matter on earth. Just now we have discussed about the plasma, but may be the most common state of matter in the universe. For example, stars including sun are covered in plasma. Bose-Einstein content state is a gas-like state of matter that exists at extremely cold temperature. It was predicted around 1925 and confirmed 1995. This is used in the field of cryogenics. It was predicted around 1925 and confirmed 1995. This is used in the field of cryogenics. What is cryogenics? Cryogenics is defined as the scientific study of material and their behavior at extremely low temperature. Next one, physical nature of matter. So based on the physical nature of matter, there are three states, solid, liquid, gas. Molecules are tightly packed. They are often hard and rigid. But liquid molecules are loosely packed as compared to that of a solid. A common or traditional definition of matter is anything that has mass and volume. For example, a car would be said to be made up of matter as it has mass and volume. So it occupies space. The observation that matter occupies space goes back to the antiquity. Physical nature of matter. Matter occupies space and has mass. But what is its nature? So ancient philosopher pondered over such questions. An Indian philosopher named Kannada and Greece philosopher named Democritus. Democritus came to somewhat similar idea. Imagine you have a piece of thread. You cut it into two with the same space. Take again one of the piece and cut it again into two. Repeat the above process for many times. At some point, piece of thread will be so small to see. That means a point. Or we may not have sharp enough knife to cut further. But this is imaginary thought experiment. Therefore, these are not possible practically. Imagine if you can cut as fine as possible and are able to see even the very small things. Can we cut the rope into two without an end? Kannada and Democritus said no. We cannot go on endlessly. There will be a point at which we will not be able to cut the thread further. That is the point which we will reach the molecules or atoms. The tiny particle is known as atoms. Gold is made up of tiny gold particles. Water is made up of tiny water particles. All matter is made up of very small particles. Gold is made up of tiny gold particles. Water is made up of tiny water particles. These tiny particles present in all matter are called as atoms or molecules. The tiny particle of a chemical element, which may or may not exist independently, is called an atom. The tiny particle of a chemical element, which may or may not exist independently, is called an atom. Molecules refer to the set of the atom held together by the bond, indicating the smallest unit of compound. Two or more identical or different atoms bonded chemically. See here the structure of atom and molecules. Already we known very well matter. Matter is anything that has mass and volume. Mass is the quantity of matter, a substance or object. So the amount of matter contained in a body is called mass. Mass is usually measured in gram or kilogram. Volume is the amount of space taken up by a substance or object. So volume is usually measured in millimeters, that means milliliters, ml, or liters, L, or cubic centimeters, centimeter cube. Do you know, children, atoms in a drop of water is equal to 3 atoms by molecule into 1.67 in 10 to the power 21 molecules. Atoms in a drop of water is 5.01 into 10 to the power 21 atoms. So the drop of water contains about 10 to the power 23 water particles. One dot that you make with your pen has more than 2 lakh molecules. Okay, children, we will meet at next class. Thank you.